I'm 15 years old and I'm from Brazil.
I was born in Malaysia.
Houston, Texas.
I was born in Quito, Ecuador, but I was raised and my family is from Oakland, California.
Then I moved to China, where I lived for 7 years.
And then I moved to KL.
I was born here in KL.
I've been to Singapore for 2 years, then I've been to Malaysia for 2 years, and then I went back to Bangladesh for 4.5 years.
I was born in Hanover, Germany.
Then moved to Germany and lived there for 3 years.
And then from KL, I moved to Singapore. And from Singapore, I moved to Islamabad, a really fun place.
My mom is Malaysian and my dad is French.
My mom is from Namibia and my dad is German.
My dad is Pakistani. My mom was born and raised in the US.
I have been traveling around for a very long time of my childhood.
I guess this is what my life is gonna be. I'm gonna be moving around all the time.
I think as a third culture kid, when you're constantly moving around, you often feel very alone and you feel that no one understands you and that no one understands what you're experiencing.
I feel like they don't understand me sometimes. I just felt like I was so different to everyone else.
They're dealing with a lot of emotions way earlier than some kids would.
It's become a part of me whether I like it or not.
I'm not really sure which culture I'm in.
He's from the US, he's from Europe, he's from Asia, you know, just we all sort of clicked with each other.
I met people that totally just challenged the way I had thought before. I'm afraid to miss a moment
where I'm free. Usually by default, I just say American, but then at the same time, I really think culture isn't a lot just an identity. And I think no one's really true cultured anymore.
That's kind of the whole point of being a third culture kid is you're constantly on the move.
Being able to adapt quickly to new situations and different places.
Everybody knows that they're gonna leave at some point.
And I just want to let everyone know that there are people like you around the world and you are not alone.
You're forced constantly out of your comfort zone. Getting exposed to cultures, holidays that you didn't know existed, people that you didn't know existed, all of these things really help shape your own view of the world.
I'm really passionate about film, which is one of the many reasons why I wanted to do this project. When I was in China, I lived in this kind of bubble. And when I moved to Berlin, it was a completely different environment, a completely different culture, something that I wasn't used to. My first day in school in Germany was horrifying. It was probably one of the worst days of my life so far. I just had to just figure out everything at once. I dealt with just not fitting in as well there just because of my appearance. I was actually bullied because I looked different, because I looked Asian.
I remember someone saying once to me, like, to pick a race. They're like, just pick a race, pick one. Like, you're four things, just pick one. Like, I can't pick one. My mother is Italian, but from Australia. And my father is Indian, but from Malaysia. So I'm a very mixed kid. Everything that I've ever known is more Italian than anything else, although I'm from all these cultures.
I spent a lot of my childhood jumping around. My dad's Pakistani, and I lived all over the place. I barely lived in the US, really. But then, of course, you can never be too American unless you got like blonde hair and white skin. I mean, I speak Urdu, but I don't really fit in with that group. By default, I just kind of say either US or I say, well, I'm living in Malaysia, because I just kind of feel that's what's more relevant.
The first move from the UK to the US really just, that changed me. It was scary for one, and it crushed me because I had so many friends in the UK. There was so much I knew about the UK. You don't feel accepted, really. Nobody's willing to just open up their group and have another person come in. I don't feel like I belong with them. But obviously, I'm not going to argue with my parents when they want to move.
I think where I grew up was definitely diverse. I was surrounded by friends who had two moms, two dads, that were immigrants, Islamic, Jewish, lived in the ghetto. And as I moved over to Asia and was living in an international school, diversity was kind of redefined so that I could then understand what being international meant. So that has definitely changed how I interact as I go back home.
Islamabad was the really big different one for me, because when I was living there, there was nothing to do there. There were no brands and there were no malls. At the time, I didn't like it when I was 8 years old, you know. Then there was a lot of poverty there as well, which also helped put things into perspective for me. And I was young and more impressionable and wasn't 100% sure of what was going on. But I think it all slipped in subconsciously. But then afterwards, more recently, I've come to appreciate it, because I kind of felt that I lived a really genuine childhood because of those 2.5 years there.
As a third culture kid, when you move around a lot, I think you learn how to be more independent and as well as emotionally mature.
Being a TCK is constantly getting used to change. As TCKs, we're forced into situations that we have to adapt to. New countries, new homes, new friends.
I was like, I guess I just gotta get used to it. I gotta find a way to like this. So my way to find a way of liking it was, this is a new culture, it's a new environment, these are new people. I just have to adapt and fit in.
That's definitely something in the TCK, you know, manual that no one gives you, that you just kind of have to deal with.
Just learning to adapt into a different culture, different country, community is, I think, a skillful skill.
That skill that we just are constantly using in our lives can then be put into smaller, more specific things, like just being put into group projects with people who you would think are so different from you, but then you just adapt.
You're going through so many different things and so many different emotions are like overwhelming you at once.
I met people that totally just challenged the way I had thought before, with different views and just being raised in different cultures.
I went to an international school in Namibia, but most of the people were from Namibia. So moving here, there were so many different cultures and it was hard to adapt, but I made friends that I would have never like met anywhere else. For the first year, it was hard because I've never lived in Asia, so it was a very different experience for me. Also meeting new people.
In the beginning, you need to learn to be very respectful of other people's cultures and their traditions.
It made me more open-minded and accepting of different religions, cultures, and just learning more about everything.
I think it's so cool to be able to grow up with people that are different and are not the same as you and have different cultures and different homes they go to at the end of the day.
I guess I'd identify as a third culture kid. I'm not really sure which culture I'm in.
We speak Portuguese at home and we eat Brazilian food, and most of my family lives in Brazil. But when I go to Brazil, I don't quite fit in as well, which is something that just confuses me even more. So I don't think I really have a dominant culture.
At home, we always eat Spanish food. We always talk in Spanish. So primarily, I guess that's my dominant culture. When I go to Spain, it's like more of a temporary visit. I don't consider that my home because here it feels a lot more like home. When I go back to Spain, it's a little bit different. It's a little bit like sometimes I don't fit in as much.
I feel like I don't really identify back home as much anymore. When we go back to Canada, a lot of people don't realize the life that we live here, and they often automatically think of what they see in the news and what these countries are portrayed to be as.
At home, since I live with my mom, and I often see my family members who are also in Malaysia, and that's when my Malaysian aspect of me comes out the most. So I think it's just like, here in school, it's more of the French, and at home or with family members, it's more of the Asian.
If it wasn't for an international school, I'd probably be the same as my Spanish cousins who find some of the things here weird. In a way, I'm more open-minded than them.
The more you know about the world, the more open-minded you can be, the more sensible you can be.
When I go back, I kind of feel a bit awkward talking about my experiences sometimes because they can't really relate to the same thing that I relate to.
It has opened my mindset to accept new cultures.
It has definitely shaped me as a person.
I feel that I belong here more than I belong back in the States. When I go back there, it feels sometimes that I'm an outsider there, whereas here I feel like I'm an insider. I feel more comfortable simply because I've been living here so much longer and I'm used to the cultures and everything that I'm around.
So when I did come to Malaysia, I was kind of disappointed and I wouldn't adjust very well. I think it took me about 7 months to adjust, make some friends.
When I arrived here, I was kind of, not traumatized, but I was scared, you know, I didn't know what to expect. So when I walked into the classroom, I was really surprised that people were actually nice to me.
I've been in the Malaysian school system, the Australian school system, and now the American school system, all in this country. And I've lived here predominantly for most of my life. So coming into the international school system, it was a big change for me. In the Malaysian system, I was kind of seen as an outcast. With MKIS, when I come into the school, you get a sense of like a community because you walk in and you just see all of the flags are around and you see all these different cultures and you know that they're representing all these different countries. But in my old school, there was only one flag that was up.
I remember I was welcomed. It was much more welcoming than my first day at public school in the States. Everyone was a lot more outgoing, you know, hi, I'm Ralph, I'm Daniel, you know, it almost felt like everyone just wanted to be my friend.
Does it matter that you're from a different country? Does it matter that you have parents from different countries? None of that matters in a school like this.
Looking back on it now, I just realize how we didn't really pay attention to where everyone was from. We just sort of became friends, regardless of, oh, he's from the US, he's from Europe, he's from Asia, you know, just, we all sort of clicked with each other.
Everybody is so much more open-minded here. It doesn't matter where you come from here, it doesn't matter what your past has been, it doesn't matter what your background is. People want to hear your story. They want to hear what makes you you. And I think that's the speciality that everybody here has.
I could say what I felt, and my opinions mattered, but back there, no one really wanted to know what my opinions were.
Everybody has had similar experiences to what you've had. Obviously, none of them are the exact same, but knowing that there's people around you who felt the same things as you and who were able to leave their friends and come to a new place and make new friends again, that's kind of, it's a big confidence booster.
this school cares more about what you want than what they want you to do. We're given a task and we're allowed to think creatively and do things the way we want to do it. I came to this school and just by doing art for even one semester, I started to really like fall in love with it again. I got to learn about different styles, different techniques. You don't have to be the best at what you do, but you're given an opportunity.
We love Seth. He's the one who did so well in school. That Seth, he's really going to be something one day.
I think that in the school, and I think in many other international schools, they teach you how to think differently and how to be independent.
I've been able to do a lot here at a small school in the theater community. I've been given a lot of opportunities to perform and a lot of leadership that I certainly would not have had back home.
Grains, grains, nothing but grains, parsley, peppers, carrots, celery, asparagus, and watermelons, and all right.
I love performing as well. I think the guitar in particular is a very expressive instrument. So I just feel that expression, those imperfections, are really good at, you know, kind of presenting what you feel.
The people who you surround yourself with actually shape your personality, and you know, with all the different cultures you're experienced to, like you're kind of like all mushed and blended into one.
Our school is a smaller school. We are all kind of like a family and we all look out for each other. When I'm older, I do want to try and give my children the experience that my parents gave me, because I think it was so amazing to grow up in an international community, and I want to be able to give the same to my children.
The International Baccalaureate is a program that was designed, right, to bring a lot of the skills and things that are needed in today's world together. It offers a rigorous academic program, but also a focus on the development of the student as a whole.
Taking the IB is it's a fantastic thing to do, because it gives you so many more opportunities.
I am a big supporter of the IB in my subject because it allows us to teach whatever we want in terms of the region that we're in.
It does prepare you a lot for being a global citizen and also going into university.
How about a reverse thought?
I feel comfortable as I go into college.
I think it's recognized globally by a lot of universities as being one of the top projects to do as a student.
It prepares you to be a very good citizen of the world, because it also brings the idea of international mindedness.
Therefore responsible for taking a stand on these and other global issues? And if we are responsible, to what extent should we take action?
While it's difficult at first and definitely very stressful at times because there's so much work you have to do in a short amount of time, once you get through it, that feeling of, wow, I did it, this sort of accomplishment feeling, it's really rewarding.
At the beginning, there's a lot of stress and anxiety in terms of how to get things done, and by the end of it, they've understood themselves and they've understood what system works for them.
It definitely is a system that is hard and requires time, but if you put that time in, you will get everything out.
You can either keep your head and your shoulders on the ground, or you can try to lift it, there you go.
It involves activity, involves service, involves creativity subjects, which is part of CAST projects, which you have to do as a full IB student.
I also did something called Care to Run. What it was basically was on weekends we would go to a park with children that have autism, and we would play games with them or just jog with them or something, just to keep them active and distract them so that their symptoms and stuff wouldn't be as extreme.
For my creativity is I created golf videos to help beginners, and I just explained the different swings and all. But people do all kinds of things.
We really need a new generation that's a lot more open-minded. And I think schools like these, which has people from all around the world and taking IB at the same time, it can really help to create more of an open mind.
Students have to cover six different areas of studies. And within those six areas of studies, it's not only about the content, but it's about the skills they learn. And there's a high emphasis on skills such as thinking skills, communication skills, social skills are very important, self-management, and researching as well.
The thing that I learned most from IB that will help me in my future is the critical thinking and analysis that was needed.
Time management and making sure that you have all the tools and resources you need to complete a project and task.
Being able to write better, being able to present better, because there are tons of presentations there too. But also, it gives you the mind of an adult.
The biggest benefit of studying the IB is time management.
That's a skill that you'll always need.
If you put all of those that look like very basic skills, but in the complexity of each of the different groups, the arts, the sciences, the language, the maths, the individuals and societies, which is like social studies, right? It gives you a very complete panorama of the world.
What better way to learn those skills when you're here in a small, caring environment?
You become a more independent learner. You're not spoon-fed. There's some things that you have to go and figure out for yourself.
It's not just me telling them. It's them coming up with their own ideas. And that's really what it's all about, I think.
That's pretty much what makes you into the best student you can be.
The world today is not only about the lawyers and the doctors and the scientists. You don't have to become a living encyclopedia to be successful. You just have to know where to look and what to do and how to work with others. And that's the beauty of the program.
I hope that in 10 years' time I would have lived in at least two more countries. And I would have gained new experiences, and I'm hoping to go to university in Europe and travel around Europe.
Probably New York or LA, doing film. I know that film is something that is really hard to succeed in, but I hope that in 10 years I'll be happy doing what I'm doing.
Somewhere in the US or Canada, I intend to have something to do with public speaking or a presenter of types.
This is Luca's guide to surviving middle school.
I don't really see myself in 10 to 15 years living in Spain. So I think maybe somewhere else in Europe.
I am a TCK, third culture kid in every way.
One of my biggest fears is being stuck.
Hoping that I'm gonna have a job that moves me around, because I can't stand staying in one place.
I just want to be stable while still having enough time for myself to do what I really want.
Possibly doing something in the film industry, working my way up.
Both my parents are teachers, and as long as I can remember, my family's been telling me, oh, you're going to be a teacher too.
I picture myself as an interior designer, helping people create new homes.
I see myself as a successful businesswoman.
Going into marketing and a bit like of the business side is something that I really see myself doing.
I don't know if I'm gonna still be like professionally performing, maybe as a side thing, as a hobby.
It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right.
having a good job, probably married, I don't know, and living in a place that's close to my immediate family.
Hopefully becoming a professional golfer. That's my main goal and aspiration for after college. So I just want to get my degree as a, you know, fallback safety net.
Be more like a worldly citizen and just see different cultures and experience different things.
I think it's important to have dreams and want stuff, you know, but I think you also have to be realistic with a lot of things.
You never know when something great's gonna happen. Work hard, dream big.
All the experiences that I've had, the food, nasi lemak, all the good stuff.
The skyscrapers, the city life here.
Being able to wear a t-shirt and shorts every single day of my life.
Cheap, good food, except for durian.
The accessibility to things.
Being here for so long, I don't really like the cold anymore.
This school, the community, all the people I know here, my friends, I'm definitely gonna miss them the most, but I know my memories and my experiences that I have here are ones that I'm gonna carry forward when I move back to Canada.
Friends of many different cultures, I get to know so many people, and once I go overseas, it'll be different.
The friendly people, for sure. Everybody here is very friendly and welcoming. I'm also gonna miss some of the teachers, because some of the teachers here are they're really nice and they're really caring and they're funny as well.
I will definitely miss my friends here because I know a lot of them are either going to the US, Canada, or they're going back home.
I'll miss the community here. They're really nice, friendly people, and I wouldn't be exposed to them if it wasn't a third culture kid.
It's definitely the environment. It's the way that you can connect with anybody here and the way that nobody has anything against each other.
When I'm walking through the hallway, I know everybody who I'm looking at.
It's like you're in a close-knit family, kind of, even though you're not directly related.
There's the benefit to that because everyone just knows each other, everyone's really close to each other.
I just feel like I'll miss the environment because it was a consistency for me. Everyone's more relaxed and I'll miss that.
Living 9 years of my life in Malaysia, it's pretty much become my home and it's almost like I'm leaving home.
You go. There you are.
Unless you make mistakes.